Do you want to build a better, smarter form so that you can increase your conversions that you're capturing, whether that's on your website or some form that you're sharing in a link? Well, if so, you are going to love this video because new features have just been released from our favorite form tool, Fillout. Fillout is a no-code form software that is going to now help you get even more conversions. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the owner at Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. In this video, we're going to be talking about Fillout's newest feature, their conversion kit, that only launched just a week ago, and I gotta say, has some really impressive features in it. But before we get into the video content itself, I first want to invite you to join me to level up your no-code knowledge. If you're new to no-code, or if you've been doing this for a while and you need a refresher, grab my free training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. This training is going to walk you through the core fundamentals of building no-code automation so that you can start reclaiming your valuable time. Go ahead and sign up for that and get instant access to that training. You can find the links wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. And I first want to start with the email that I received from Fillout just a week ago. Here it is inside of my email. We see that they have announced their brand new world of form builders, their new conversion kit. They mentioned that they've been working on this for several months, beta testing with their forms to see some really good results. Here it is, Fillout's conversion kit. And in short, what is it? You've got the optimization of your forms to reduce drop-offs. The whole idea here is that when people come to your form, you want to capture all the data that you are looking to capture, but you want to make it as low friction for your prospective client or whoever it is that's filling out your form as possible. The less friction points that you present to them, the increased opportunity, the increased rate that you will see in terms of conversions on your forms. And that is exactly what this is all about. As they say right here in the email, this is particularly well suited for lead generation. And because Fillout is covering the costs for these external services like Clearbit, Google Maps, etc., the conversion kit is an optional paid add-on to Fillout. So this is something that you can toggle on, pay a little bit extra every month on your Fillout account, but you are going to get these impressive features. Now, before we go on, I welcome you to join me side by side in your own Fillout account. If you don't have Fillout yet, please use our link. I will share it wherever you found this video. You can sign up there for a free trial. All right, let's go ahead and see what this conversion kit is all about. Here is Fillout's landing page on this new feature. So here we go. Routing leads to the right place. So the ability to qualify and route leads. We could kind of do this before with some fancy form logic, but this is one of the key features of this new opportunity. This one is new to me, email validation, making sure that people are using company-only emails and that they are valid email addresses. Knowing this before somebody even submits a form is going to reduce your collection of faulty or bad data and make sure that you are getting high qualified leads every time. It's also allowing us to do some smart scheduling. Not only is Fillout connecting to Calendly, but also Cal.com and Chili Piper and other schedulers directly in the form. We can also recover lost leads. So notify the team whenever a prospect drops off. So as you see in the little visual diagram here, we can see that the form was not submitted. So we send an email if we go down this route, or if the form is submitted, then we never see this email that comes out to our team. And on that note, that is highlighting this right here, the abandoned form email, so that we can nudge leads who drop off in order to not complete the form. And then we also have boosting conversion with autocomplete. So using things like autofill, dynamic form shortening, and a Google Maps autocomplete. I'm going to show you exactly how this works in our demo here. This is really cool because we can actually say, hey, if we actually know some information about this person based on our autocomplete feature, we just remove those elements from the form, shorten the form, and therefore increase our conversion rate. This is massive. Now, coming soon, not yet available as of this recording, is the ability to optimize ad campaigns. And you better believe I am super excited to be jumping in on this, because one of the biggest things that we're losing in the no-code space right now is this optimization of ad campaigns and having this baked into the solution already, right into Fillout, which is capturing all of our lead information already. This is massive, massive opportunity here, and I cannot wait until this new feature is also released. Now, we have everything here: lead generation, form essentials, custom domain, monitoring drop-off, etc., etc. All of this for $50 extra on your plan per month. And with that, you will get 100 enriched leads. And if you need more than that, bulk discounts are available for additional leads. All of those things that we just mentioned for this $50 a month add-on. Let's get to actually showing you what that looks like, because I've been granted access to this feature. I want to showcase a couple here. Now, the first one I want to do is bring in an email address. Let's have an email input here. And so if we were building a form in Fillout, just as I've done, and I add this email field over here on the right-hand side, because we have conversion kit, I can click enrich. And look at the more advanced options I now get. Disallow free email accounts. I mouse over here. Anybody who tries to fill this out with a Yahoo, a Hotmail, a Gmail, they will not be able to submit this form. They cannot proceed. They have to actually submit a valid email address that is on a paid email account. So presumably a business email address. You are going to get better qualified leads, and make sure that you're talking to real decision makers by toggling this on. So here we go. We have a free email error message. We can say something like, by default, it says, provide a business email. That's fine. This is what the form respondents will see if a free email domain is provided. We'll test this out here at the end, so stay tuned for that. Next, we have the validate email address option. If we hover over here, we can only allow valid emails to be submitted. And this is done because Fillout calls this third-party service to check if the email is valid. I can't even believe that this is a legit thing, that this actually works. How awesome is this? How often do I, as a business owner, wind up getting forms that are submitted where somebody typed their email address incorrectly? One letter on that typo, and now we lose the email. We lose that opportunity. If we could validate that that is a proper email address before submission, we can stop that from happening right there at the form submission stage. This is massive, definitely turning this on, and we can then update what that invalid email error message is. And by default, it's gonna say, please provide a real email. Awesome. Now, lastly, I'm coming down to Clearbit here. We can enrich data collected in the overall form thanks to Clearbit. So what they say here is Fillout will enrich the email address with Clearbit. This will add additional information to the email address, like the name, company, company size, and job title. So Clearbit presumably has this information on us if it's publicly available already. So when somebody's putting in their email address, they don't have to fill out the rest of this stuff. We can just streamline the whole process and have that all done for them. So let's toggle this on and demo this as well. You'll notice that when I toggle it on, I get this right here that says, leads are automatically being enriched. View enriched details on the results tab or use them in form logic. So if we were to bring this into the form, we can autofill other pieces of the form based on the information that we know because of their email address, or we can shorten the form. So if we shorten the form, it will dynamically show fields in the form only if we are unable to find them based on email. So for example, imagine a form where I put in my email address and Clearbit, which Fillout partners with, Clearbit already knows my name, my phone number, my address. Well, now when I'm filling out the next part of the form, I don't have to give that information. All I had to do was give my email address and the rest of it got shortened for me. And I don't even see those questions. The form automatically captures the data. Or I can autofill it so that maybe the person says, well, that's not actually the phone number I want to give you, but that is a valid phone number, for example. So how do we get this to work? Well, we have to add the other fields here. So let's add name. Lead first name, this is what I want. I don't have a question for it yet, so I have to create that question. And let's bring in the lead last name as well. And I will also bring in the company name and the job title. Let's just see what Clearbit knows about me. I'm gonna use myself as a guinea pig here. Let's close this down. I'm gonna build those other questions in the form. So short answer, this is gonna be first name. And let's duplicate this, but this will be last name now. And let's see, I also had company, so let's duplicate again for company. And what else did we bring in back here? I have to go back into my settings to remind myself what else I had. So that was in my edit enrichment settings. Let's go there. I have my first name, got it. Got my last name, got my company name, and it was the job title. Okay. Well, rather than delaying this any longer, let's cut this out and see if we can fill out this information. Presumably, when I go to fill this out, if I put in my valid email address, it'll fill out my first name, last name, and company as well. Now, that's not the only thing I want to showcase here. Let's bring an address field in as well. So here I'm going to just look for address, and we can add that to our form, drop it on down here. And here on our address, I'm going to enable the autocomplete. Again, on the right-hand side of the screen over here, because I have Conversion Kit enabled, I see this. So if I toggle that option, I can go to Address Autocomplete, hover over here, and we see that autocomplete addresses for users using the Google Maps API, available on Fillout Enterprise plans. Contact Fillout Support for more details. Outstanding. Let's toggle this on. We have to refresh the page to enable this autocomplete, which I will refresh, do a little F5, get that going. And now when I start to fill out this form, we will see that get auto-populated. So that's a lot. That's a lot right there. But you see, I built all of this in what? A matter of minutes? Let's go ahead and publish this form and take it out for a spin. Let's see if it is as smart as I hope it is. I'm going to go ahead and preview the form. Here it is. If I put in my actual email address, what happens? Here we got a spinny wheel, it's searching, and it's valid. So this is a valid email address. It hasn't rejected it, which is great. But what happens if I use a different email address? We see here that it did not fill out my first name, last name, company, and obviously I haven't even started with the address yet. So it does not know this information about me, which, to be honest with you, I'm kind of glad about because I don't need all of that information out there. But I have an old email address. Before we switched over to Gap Consulting, it was gareth@garethpronovost.com. I wonder if this one has information known about it. It sure does. I am not surprised because this is the one where I get all my spam right now. So obviously there's a lot of databases out there that have this email address. But you can see that when I filled out that information, it filled out my name. Gareth Pronovost, Gap Consulting, it knows who I am. It's filled out this information, saving me steps. Now remember the way we did this, we said autofill the form, but we could also hide these fields dynamically. We could say, oh well, we know your first name and last name, so we're not even going to show them to you, therefore shortening the form and therefore increasing conversions. All right, before we get out of here, let's check out this address. Let's just say I've got a fake address. As I start filling this out, you see that different responses come back here. And as I type an address in, it further reduces. We've seen this in a lot of different form softwares before, but being able to have all of this information just immediately populate like that saves me, as the person filling out the form, so much time, so much energy. It's so much more simple for me to put in my information and to make sure that I don't make a typo. There's no room for error when I'm selecting this address from a dropdown. So not only is it easier for people to fill out your information in the form, it's also going to mean that you don't have to worry about bad information. And again, like I mentioned earlier, bad information can kill your entire form submission. If somebody types in the wrong email address, toast, right? What happens if, for example, and this is a real life example, just the other day, someone filled out, but rather than putting C-O-M, they accidentally put C-O-N. Now, obviously, in this example, it was easy for me to look at the email and know that there was a typo. I can fix that. But you'll notice that here, somebody cannot submit this. please enter a real email address. Or what happens if I'm using the Gmail or a Yahoo or something like that? They're going to get stopped again saying, this is not a business email address. So this kind of data validation is going to help you drive amazing new conversions. If you are running a business that uses Fillout to collect your form software, this conversion kit might be the thing you need to really drive new revenue as you move forward. I know we went pretty fast in this video, but this is a pretty exciting topic and there's a lot to it. So drop any questions that you might have below wherever you found the video. And in the meantime, friend, keep on building.